Hey, you're watching With Wendy, and today I'm going to show you how I made this super easy wool cake. Ah, all its wooliness.
Hongi!
That's Sunny.
And Adele.
Eating my goods because we're about to cross the border.
Wait, we still have one more orange.
Oh, well, if you peel it for me, I'll eat it.
Hongi has a thing against peeling oranges.
I just don't like the smell.
The smell of your nails.
Hello everyone, we passed through Pennsylvania, Ohio, and New York. Now we're going to Illinois. Shoved all of this in this morning.
Back here.
Oh no.
I feel like capes are kind of having a moment right now, and they're a very good transitional piece going into the winter. It's like one step preppier and fancier than a blanket scarf, but then not totally committed to peacoat or like winter parka. They're also very high impact in the way that they look. There's a lot of flow and movement to them, and the bigger you make the cape, the more it moves. I chose a particularly flowy style. It was actually based off of a item that I found online. I'll put a link down there. That item was $1,000, I think. I was like, yeah, let's not pay so much money for something that I can try to make myself. The style that I based it off of doesn't have any closures. It just has this like half scarf attachment that you go whoosha over your shoulder with. That ended up being kind of nice because I find closures and snaps and buttons, those are the kinds of things where it's like the last step of the cape, but if you do it wrong, it can cause lumps and for it to be ill-fitting. And I just like the idea that you could curl all up in it, toss over your shoulder, and get on with your day. Mine was $60 of wool, so still not on that super cheap end, but I mean, if you're wanting to wear this in the winter for years to come and it's great wool, $60 is not too bad of a price for a beautiful wool cape. If you really want to make this but you can't afford the $60, there's also a way you could do it with heavy knit or fleece, and in some cases those are cheaper than wool. As always, there is a step-by-step breakdown I put in the description for you. Let's see how truly easy this cape is. To make this wool cape, there'll be four different types of pieces you'll need. I'll put the full dimensions in a link in the blog for you. First piece is the biggest piece, and it's going to make up the body of the cape. Mine is roughly one big square. The second piece is the scarf. It's a long, thin rectangle. Then there are four little rectangles to seal off the pocket holes. And finally, two larger rectangles to be the pockets. We'll start by hemming all of the free edges of the biggest piece. I fold it in about 1 centimeter and sew with a straight stitch all the way around. Taking the front half of the body piece, I cut it straight down the middle about halfway in, and then add a neck hole. The neck hole is about 4 inches wide in all directions and deeper in the front. Taking those two straight edges that we just cut, we'll also need to hem these ones in about 1 centimeter as well. With those two front edges that we just hemmed, we're going to fold them in about 2 inches and then add a straight stitch along the bottom to keep that in place. Now we are ready for the pockets. Take those four pieces, fold them in half so that the right side is on the outside, and seal it with a straight stitch. With the bigger rectangles right side up, we're going to use a straight stitch to attach those pocket flaps on both edges. Once that's done, you can lift one of the pocket flaps and bring it so that it's touching the other one edge to edge, and then we'll sew it down on the two sides of the pocket. Here are your pockets all done. Our next step is to attach them to the cape. To position the pocket, I put it about 5 inches up from the bottom and 8 inches in from the front edge of the cape. Making sure that the slit I cut is not any wider than the pocket opening, I use 2 pins to mark where to start and stop, and then cut a straight slit. On the 2 edges of that slit, I add a small cut on a diagonal for both ends so that it forms a little V. All of these corners that you've cut when unfolded are going to give you the rectangular shape for your pocket hole. Now with the 2 front pieces of the cape stacked on top of each other, you can use that to measure out where the second slit is going to be so that they are symmetrical to each other. Fold one of the sides in half so that that pocket slit is along the edge, and then slide the pocket underneath. We're going to be tucking that pocket edge inwards and then pinning it down to the pocket hole. Once you're done tucking and pinning, you can unfold that front of the cape and then tuck and pin the opposite side. I took the opportunity to reverse the pins on top so that they all go in a clockwise direction, and then also folded in the 2 V's on the side and added a pin on each. First, we'll sew the edge that is closer to the front of the cape, then we'll go around the remaining edges using a straight stitch. The reason we have to separate this into 2 steps is because if you simply sew a rectangle around the entire opening, you'll actually end up sealing off the entire pocket. So first, we have to do 1 edge, having all of the pocket fabric out of the way, and then on the other side, we can finish it off by doing the remaining 3 edges. If you are super new to sewing, remember that pockets are also very optional, so you can feel free to skip this step if you like. Okay, we're gonna add that scarf piece. First, I take the long rectangle and hem all of the edges just like I did with the body of the cape. Folding in the front edge of the cape about 2 inches, we're going to start pinning the scarf all along the neckline. On the left side of the cape, I added the scarf at about 8 inches in and just started to pin all the way around until I'm about 8 inches down on the other side. Once you're done pinning, you can just sew straight across. For our final touches on the cape, we're going to tuck that pocket flap inside of the front edge of the cape and then sew it down with a needle and thread. I'm only sewing through the pocket layer and the flap layer, but not the front of the cape because I don't want this little thing that I'm sewing to be visible from there. This is going to prevent the pocket from flapping around in the wind when you're wearing the cape. For those of you that need a close-up, here it is. As you can see, I'm just going through those 2 layers with the needle, but not that 3rd one, which is the outside of the cape, and I don't want this to show. I'm just going back and forth until I'm happy with how secure it is, and then I'm going to tie a knot. Here's how I always tie my knots. I wind the thread around the needle about 2 times, pull it really close to the opening, and then pull the needle through. Then I repeat it 1 more time, winding the needle, pushing it down, and then pulling everything through. This keeps the knot really close to the opening. To really finish things off, I also took the scissors and cut off those unsightly tabs that are beside the pocket, and this cleans the whole thing up and it's ready for you to wear. If you liked this tutorial, let me know, and obviously if you end up making your own, please tag me or show me somehow. You can find me on Instagram or Snapchat under @withwendy, and if you want to see more of my tutorials in the future, you are always welcome to subscribe. Next week I will be back with another tutorial. I hope you guys are all well, and I will see you later. Bye!